The current Ebola outbreak in Western Africa is the largest that humanity has ever experienced. Will we ever have a vaccine for this scary disease? Hey, this is Carin for DNews. The ongoing Ebola epidemic in several Western African countries continues to dominate news headlines, and for good reason. In today's global society, the potential for spread of a virus like this is massive. Ebola is easily transmissible between humans through body fluids, which is why those that are at the highest risk of contracting it are healthcare providers and family members of those that are already sick. There is currently no cure for Ebola, and between 50 and 90% of those that catch the virus will die from it. Those that manage to fight through the infection generally do so through supportive healthcare measures like blood pressure and oxygen maintenance, and medications to control fever, allow the blood to clot, and to prevent other infections. There's currently no available vaccine for Ebola, although a study recently published in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences shows that scientists are making significant progress in developing one for wild gorillas and chimpanzees. Now, you may not know that Ebola is actually one of the leading killers of wild apes. It's actually killed over one-third of the world's gorilla population, leading to their status as critically endangered. Now, because the Ebola virus spreads so easily, conservationists generally support vaccine development, even though they are potentially dangerous. Vaccines involve administering small doses of the offending bacteria or virus to the body so that our immune systems can mount an appropriate response. This way, we become preemptively prepared in case we ever come into contact with the pathogen again. This is where it's tricky to develop vaccines for diseases like Ebola. There is no amount that is safe to administer to apes or humans. However, scientists have produced what seems to be an effective Ebola vaccine using a virus-like particle, a fragment of viral coat protein. Now, since a fully replicating virus is not being transferred, this is a much safer way to make use of the natural immune reactions in the animals that are receiving it. Now, studies in the past have demonstrated that this virus particle vaccine is both safe and effective in macaques, one of our primate cousins. But the vaccine was recently administered to chimpanzees, and it was found to be safe as well. Now, just to be clear, chimpanzees were not challenged with the Ebola virus itself. They were inoculated with the particle vaccine in order to see if it was safe for their bodies and to see if they could mount a suitable immune response. And they could. Antibodies harvested from vaccinated chimps were transferred to mice, who were then challenged by the Ebola virus, and the mice were all protected. Okay, so this is huge news for wild ape populations worldwide, and it's potentially good news for humans too. The NIH has just announced plans to fast-track this vaccine and two others to phase one clinical trials this September. It seems like the use of a viral particle vaccine represents a very promising technique for protecting us from deadly pathogens like Ebola. What do you think? Should we be putting more effort into developing an Ebola vaccine? Let us know in the comments below and click here to subscribe for more DNews every day of the week.